The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, second chapter, text number 23, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on November 27, 1972, in Hyderabad, India.
Here is the import of Sanātana. Nitya sarvagata sthānu asalayam Sanātana. Sanātana, here is mention of Sanātana in another place, in the 7th chapter, 15th chapter. There is mention of Sanātana. Mamaivāṁsa jīva bhūta jīva loke sanātana. Another place, there is mention of Sanātana. Parastasvāstu bhāva anya bhaktya bhaktya sanātana. In another place, there is mention, in the 11th chapter, Kṛṣṇa is addressed as Sanātana. So Kṛṣṇa is Sanātana, and we living entities, we are also Sanātana. And there is a place. First tasmāta. Place means another nature. Not this nature. Not this prakriti. There is another prakriti. Para tasmāta. Para means transcendent. This nature is not Sanātana, it is asanātana, perishable. Sanātana means not perishable. this Kṛṣṇa consciousness movement is an attempt to bring all these Sanātana together. The living entity is Sanātana, God, Kṛṣṇa, Sanātana, and the place, Sanātana. Just like here, we are trying to live together, our family, father, mother, children, friends, countrymen, community men. We are trying to make a permanent settlement here. Making very nice building, spending millions of dollars, making it very strong so that it may not be destroyed. So everyone is trying to keep himself permanent. The old man is trying to make himself young man. Nobody wants to become old man. Nobody wants to be destroyed. But the difficulty is that here everything is destroyed. Asana. But we have got a tendency to become Sanātana. We want permanent life. We want permanent place, we want permanent relationship, but that is not possible. That is not possible. Therefore, Śāstra says, andhā yathānbhi rupaniyamāna. The andhā means blind, blind leaders. They are giving us false hope that we shall make here permanent settlement. Therefore they are called andhas. They have no sense. You cannot make it Sanātana, but the whole attempt is going on to make everything Sanātana. This is called illusion. Illusion means you are accepting something which is not possible. But they do not know. Nati vidushathagating hi Vishnu. Durasaya de bohirathamani. Durasaya. This is a hope which is never to be fulfilled. Durasaya. Asaya means hope. So the whole material world is going on durasaya. They are trying to make permanent settlement. But there is always disruption, fight, just like they have now created the United Nations. My dear all nations, please do not fight. Let us make a permanent settlement, peace. But the result is the fighting is going on. It cannot be stopped. Here, this is not a Sanātana place. This is impermanent, temporary, bhutta bhutta praliyate. This is the nature of this material world. Something is generated at a certain date and it stays for some time, it grows, it gives some byproducts, then again it dwindles and then it vanishes. Just like this body. This body is given by the father and mother at a certain date. Then it stays, say, for some time. It grows. Then it gives some byproduct from this body. There will be so many children. Or from the trees, there will be so many fruits and seeds. Then dwindling, then becomes older and vanishes. This is the nature. So, here we are getting information that akṣetvayam adādhyam aklidya asosraivata nitya sarvagataha. This is another qualification of the living entity. Sarvagataha. Everywhere. A rascal scientist says there is no living entity in the moon planet or sun planet. This is rascalism. There is. Otherwise, how Kṛṣṇa says, sarvagata. Everywhere there is living entity. This is a false theory. We can see practically. We see there are living entities in the water, there are living entities in the air, there is living entity within the earth. There is living entities in so many ways. Why not in other planets? What is the difference between this planet and that planet? This is also made of five elements. That is also made of five elements. Here the earthly element is very prominent and the sun globe, the fire element is very prominent. So, if this material world is made of these five elements, bhumi, rapana, lovayu, khangamana, buddhi, so, Kṛṣṇa says, sarvagat, the living entities are everywhere. Kṛṣṇa is also within everywhere. Annantarastham, paramanu, chayantarastham. Kṛṣṇa is within this universe. Kṛṣṇa is within your heart. Not only your heart, but in everyone's heart. Īśvara sarva-bhūtānām riddhese arjuna tiṣṭhati. Now, if you are a great scientist, take one insect. There are so many insects, you have seen, especially in the book. Less than the foolish dog. Now if you are a great scientist, find out where is the heart of this insect and where is Kṛṣṇa. But Kṛṣṇa says, sarvagata, everywhere there is Kṛṣṇa. Unless there is Kṛṣṇa, there is living entity, how that a small polyp-like insect is moving. There is everything. The physiological condition is there. There is heart also. You cannot make that. You have imitated a big bird, aeroplane, flying, but just imitate the small insect which is also flying. So there are so many questions that if we actually, philosophically study, then we can see Vasudeva Sarvamiti Sa Mahatma Sudurlava. How Vasudeva Kṛṣṇa is acting? Andantarastham Paramanu Sayantarastham. So, here the living entity is described as Sanātana, and the process by which we can understand our Sanātana nature, that is called Sanātana Dharma. Not that having a big tilak and considering this rascal lump of matter as I am Brahmin. This body is Brahmin and Sanātana Dharma. This is all nonsense. Sanātana Dharma means first of all you must know what you are. That is Sanātana Dharma. This Sanātana Dharma is limited to a certain area, how it can be. Sarvagata. Sanātana Dharma must be there everywhere. Īśāvāsamidam sarvam. Everywhere. Krishna's kingdom, Krishna's property. How is that? You are simply claiming that in India there is Sanātana Dharma. In India there is Brahmin. What Krishna creates, that is for everywhere. Because Krishna is the father of everyone. Aham bija padapita sarva joni sukantya. So these rascal lump, that Sanātana Dharma is only in India, and that is also cut off. Now the Pakistan is cut off, and therefore there is no Sanātana Dharma, simply here. If you remain foolish like that, then andhā yathānthi rupaniyamāna, that means you are being led by some blind leader. You do not know what is what. If living entity is Sanātana, and if the process by which one can realize his Sanātana nature, that is called Sanātana Dharma. Dharma, if you study these two words, Sanātana means eternal. That is called Sanātana. And dharma means occupation, characteristic. Dharma does not mean some superficial ritualistic ceremony. Dharma means the characteristic. That is real meaning. Dharma is not a kind of faith. Dharma is characteristic. Sanātana Dharma means Sanātana characteristic, eternal characteristic. The changing, now I have got now this body, Indian body, and then next body may be cats and dogs or demigods according to my karma. So the body changes, so Sanātana Dharma cannot be applied to this body. Sanātana Dharma means the characteristic of the soul. That is Sanātana Dharma. To understand the characteristic of the soul. Kṛṣṇa is describing here the characteristic of the soul, the Sanātana. And at the conclusion, he gives you information of the Sanātana Dharma. What is that? Sarva dharmān parityajya māṁ ekaṁ saraṇaṁ vraja. This is Sanātana Dharma. Kṛṣṇa is Sanātana. I am Sanātana. You are Sanātana. Now, under the influence of nature, I am thinking, I am the servant of my wife, I am servant of the society, I am servant of my nation, I am servant of my cat, I am servant of my dog. And we are doing that, actually. Everyone is working under this impression. Atā griha cetra sutāpta vittai janasya mohoyam ahamameti. This is illusion. You have to come to the platform of Sanātana. What is that, Sitāna? I am eternally servant of Kṛṣṇa. That is Sanātana. I am not servant of this or that or that. No. I am eternal servant of Kṛṣṇa. Jivet sarūpāy nitya Kṛṣṇa dāt. Chaitanya Mahāprabhu said that every living entity is in its original position of Kṛṣṇa consciousness. At the present moment we have got different consciousness. That is Māyā. This is mental concoction. I am thinking that I will be happy in this way. That is a mental concoction. You cannot be happy unless you surrender to Kṛṣṇa. That is Sanātana Dharma. Therefore Kṛṣṇa says, bhaunam janmanam anti. A person, after many, many births, he becomes really wise. Kamadinam kotidhana kotidha palita dunnidesa. Tisang maina karuna jata natrapa lopa shanti. A Brahmin, he prays to Kṛṣṇa, my dear Lord, I have become the servant of my senses. Here everyone is servant of his senses. They want to enjoy the senses. Not enjoy, they want to serve the senses. My tongue says, please, take me to such and such restaurant and give me such and such chicken juice. I immediately go. Not to enjoy, but to abide by the orders of my tongue. Therefore, in the name of so-called enjoyment, we are all serving the senses. In Sanskrit it is called go-das. Go means senses. So unless you become Goswami, your life is spoiled. Goswami. You cannot be dictated by the senses. You have to dictate to the senses. As soon as the tongue says, kindly take me to the restaurant or give me a cigarette. If you say no, no cigarette, no restaurant, simply Kṛṣṇa prasad, then you are Goswami. Then your Goswami. This is the character is Sanātana, because I am eternal servant of Kṛṣṇa. So, this is called Sanātana Dharma. That we are describing in the Ajāmi Lupākhya. This stage can be attained. Tapasā, brahmacarjīna, samena, dhamena, Sautena, Tyagena, Yamena, Niyamena. Therefore the whole Vedic literature is meant for how to control the senses. Yoga, yoga indriya sangya. That is yoga. Yoga means not to show some magic. This is the first class magic. If you are practicing yoga, I have seen so many so-called yogis, but they cannot control the sense for smoking. Smoking and so many things are going on, and still they are passing as a yogi. What kind of yogi? Yogi means one who has controlled the senses, pramena, dhamena, brahmacharyena. In the Bhagavad Gita, it is all explained. When yoga system is described, and 5,000 years ago, Arjuna was hearing about this yoga, controlling senses. So he was a grihastha and politician also, because he belonged to the royal family, he was fighting for gaining victory over the kingdom. So Arjuna frankly said, "My dear Kṛṣṇa, it is not possible for me to become a yogi, because this is very difficult job. You are asking me to sit down in a solitary place, in a sacred place, and in perpendicular state, simply looking on the point of your nose, of my nose. So many things are, but it is not possible for me." He frankly refused. So Kṛṣṇa just encouraged his friend and devotee. He could understand that Arjuna is becoming disappointed. He is frankly admitting that it is not possible for him. Actually, he is a politician. How it can be possible for him to become yogi? But our politicians, they are advertising, or they are practicing yoga. What kind of yoga? Has he become more than Arjuna? In this age of fallen age, 5,000 years ago, how much favorable condition was there? Now, in such unfavorable condition, deteriorated condition, you want to become a so-called yogi? It is not possible. Kīteda dhyāto Vishnu. Yoga means to meditate upon Vishnu. That was possible in the Shakta Yoga, just like Valmiki. He meditated for 60,000 of years and become perfect. So, who is going to live for 60 years? So it is not possible. So therefore, Kṛṣṇa to encourage him. Actually, the purpose of yoga, he explained to Arjuna. Yoginam api sarvesam madgata antaratmana sadhyanan bhajati jo maam samay yukta tamo mata. First class yogi. Who? Yoginam api sarvesam madgata antaratmana. Who is thinking of always of me, Kṛṣṇa. So, this Kṛṣṇa consciousness movement is educating people to become first class yogi. Think of Kṛṣṇa. Hare Kṛṣṇa, Hare Kṛṣṇa. Kṛṣṇa, Kṛṣṇa, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Ram, 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 Hare. It is not bogus thing. It is actual fact. You can become yogi. You can become Brahma. Brahma bhuyaya kalpate. Mācabhyāvicāni bhakti yogena jāsevate sagunān samatittai tān brahma bhūyāya kalpate. So one who becomes realized, self-realized person, brahma-bhūta prasannātmā, then what does it remain for him? That is the ultimate goal of life, to become aham brahmāsmi. The Vedic literature teaches us that don't think that you belong to this matter. You are Brahma. Kṛṣṇa is Parabrahma. And we are subordinate Brahma. Nitya Kṛṣṇa Das. You are servant Brahma. He is master Brahma. So instead of understanding that I am servant Brahma, I am thinking I am master Brahma. That is another illusion. That is another illusion. So things are going on there. So, Sanātana Dharma means when one understands his real position. That is self-realization. Or in other words, Kṛṣṇa is Sanātana. If you engage yourself in the service of Kṛṣṇa, then by practicing this Sanātana Dharma, you are transferred to this Sanātana place, Vaikuntha. That is Sanātana Dharma. Dharma means character. So what is our characteristic? I was going to explain that we are now serving our senses. This is our material characteristic. Material character because originally I am servant. I am not master. But I have given up service of Kṛṣṇa. Kṛṣṇa bhūlyā jīv bhogavān cha kare. Why shall I become servant? I shall become Kṛṣṇa. All right, you become Kṛṣṇa. You become enjoyer. That is material world. Everyone is trying to become Kṛṣṇa, enjoyer. So there is fight. All right, you are trying to become Kṛṣṇa. I am trying to become Kṛṣṇa. As there are so many incarnations of God nowadays, every lane, every street, so we are all imitation Kṛṣṇa and there is fight. That is a Sanātana Dharma. That is not Sanātana. Therefore, the Brahmin says, Kamadinam kotidhana kotidha palita durnidisa. My dear Lord, I tried to become master, but I have become servant of my senses. Kaam, krodh, lobh, moha, mastarja, ittari. Now, I see that I have served so long, but my so-called master, they are not satisfied. Everyone knows, even after the end of life, one tries to become master. But that is not possible, because he is not master. So when one is wise, he sees that I am actually not master. I am serving others, but I am thinking I am master. Just like in my family, I am thinking that I am the head of the family, I am the master of the family, but actually to satisfy my family members, I have to work hard day and night. So I have become their servant, but I am thinking I am master. This is called illusion. So, when one comes to the senses that he cannot be master at any stage of his life, then he surrenders to Kṛṣṇa. Sa mahatma asudullah. Vāsudeva sarvami. So, Vāsudeva is the real master. And my nature is to serve him. Vāsudeva sarvami iti. Sa mahatma asudullah. He is first class mahatma. Not the mahatma who is thinking himself that he has become Narayan and begging door to door. And Narayan is meant for begging. Narayan is the master of Lakshmi, goddess of fortune. But they have manufactured a word, Daridra Narayan. Narayan has become Daridra. Just foolishness, see. Narayan is the master of goddess of not only one goddess of fortune, Lakshmi sahasta sata sambhama sevamanam govindam adipurisam tamam. Hundreds of thousands of Lakshmi. Just like Kṛṣṇa, when he was present, he had 16,108 Lakshmi in Dwarka. That is Nara. And each Lakshmi was given a big palatial building made of marble and bedecked with jewels. So there was no need of light. Such nice marble palaces. And each queen was given 10 children. And it is not that that 16,000 queens were crying and Kṛṣṇa is only with one queen. No. He expanded himself into 16,000 forms and he was living with each queen. That is Narayan. Why Narayan should become Daridra? Narayan says that Bhoktaram Jagdutasa, he is the supreme Bhokta, enjoyer. So he is unlimited, therefore he is unlimited enjoyment. That is Kṛṣṇa. He showed it when he was present. Why 16,000 wives? If he could have 16 millions of wives, still they were not perfect. Because he is unlimited. So these things you have to understand. So this Brahman's prayer, kama-dinaṁ-kati-dhāna-kati-dhā-pālita-dhunni-desa tīsāṁ-mahīnā-kuruna-jāta natrupā-nopu-śānti sāmpratam-lubdhi-buddhi-labdham. My dear Lord, I have sought my senses so long, but I see they are not satisfied, nor they are pleased, nor there is end of their service. Therefore, now I have got good sense. I have come to serve you. Kindly accept. This is Kṛṣṇa consciousness movement. That you are engaged in service, but you are thinking as master. This is foolishness. Give up this foolishness and just become a servant of Kṛṣṇa as you are constitutionally positioned. This is Kṛṣṇa consciousness. And the every living entity is Sanātana. And Kṛṣṇa is Sanātana. And there is place in Sanātana. So our business is how to transfer ourselves in that Sanātana dhāma. Sarveshu vinasasu na vinasati. Everything being destroyed, that place, that Sanātana dhāma is never destroyed. Kṛṣṇa is never destroyed, you are also not ever destroyed. So therefore, when these three combinations will be there, that will be happy. Yadgapyāna nivartante taddhāma paramamam. Taddhāma paramam. So, we have to return to the Sanātana dharma, Sanātana dhāma, by executing our Sanātana dharma. To approach the Supreme Sanātana, Nitya-Nityānāṁ. He is the greatest Sanātana amongst the many other Sanātana. Nitya and Sanātana the same thing. Here it is said, Nitya or Sanātana. So, Kṛṣṇa is also Nitya. And I am also Nitya, you are also Nitya. So our business is to approach Kṛṣṇa and be engaged in his service for nitya, eternally. That will make us happy. Otherwise, what is this? Tilak. And considering, I am this body, Brahmin, I am this, that. That is not Sanātana dharma. Here is Sanātana dharma. Try to understand. And this Sanātana dharma should be spread all over the world for all living entities. Because all living entities are Sanātana. They should be informed that here is your position. Here is your Sanātana master. Why you are traveling? Serving your senses. This is Sanātana dharma. So this Kṛṣṇa consciousness movement is Sanātana dharma real. Not so-called Sanātana dharma. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.